Hello friends, this is Sharmila and welcome back to Sharmila's kitchen. Today I'll be making prawn chaap. It is a very tasty Mughlai dish. Generally chaap is very popularly made with chicken or mutton in Kolkata, but I also tried out with prawns for a little variation in taste and the dish turned out absolutely scrumptious. So let's look at the ingredients first. We need 4 big prawns, 1/4 teaspoon turmeric powder, 1/3 teaspoon salt or as per your taste, juice from 1/2 lime. We need to make nut masala paste. For that we need 5 to 6 cashews, raisins about 20, 2 teaspoon poppy seeds and 1 teaspoon melon seeds. First soak all these things together for 1/2 hour, then make a fine paste. After that we need 1 big onion finely sliced, 1 tablespoon ginger garlic paste, fried onion paste or brown onion paste, 4 tablespoon, 1/2 teaspoon coriander powder, about 1/2 teaspoon cumin powder, 1/4 teaspoon nutmeg and mace powder, 1/2 cup curd or dahi, salt to taste, 2 tablespoon ketchup, 1/2 teaspoon garam masala powder, 1 cup milk, 1 teaspoon keura water. We need oil about 4 to 5 tablespoon and 1 or 2 tablespoon ghee. We also need 2 to 3 cardamom pods, 2 to 3 cloves and cinnamon stick. First clean and devein the prawns. Sprinkle salt, turmeric powder and lime juice on prawns. Rub them well. Set aside for 10 minutes. Meanwhile, heat some oil in a pan. Fry the prawns until both sides become light golden brown. Once done, take them out and put on a plate. Now mix all the masala except onion, ginger garlic paste and garam masala. In a mixing bowl, add curd, fried onion paste, coriander powder, cumin powder, nutmeg and mace powder, Kashmiri red chili powder. Then I'm going to add prepared nut paste and 2 tablespoon ketchup. Twist them up. I have not used turmeric powder because the dish will get the nice red color from Kashmiri red chili powder. After whisking up, keep the masala aside. So I'm using the same oil where we fried the prawns. I'm adding some ghee to bring more flavor. When the oil is getting hot, add cardamom pods, cloves and cinnamon sticks. Just a quick saute, then add sliced onion. Fry it until they become golden brown. Then add onion paste and ginger garlic paste. Saute for few minutes. When you see the paste separates from the oil, add prepared masala. Salt to taste. Also saute it for 5 to 6 minutes on medium to low heat until the masala is nicely cooked and release the oil. Now I'm gonna add milk and mix well. Now let the gravy to come to a good boil, then we will add prawns. Now you can ask me why did I add milk and so many ingredients like cashews, raisins, melon seeds and other stuffs. It's all about making the dish delicious. Milk and nut paste make the chaap rich, creamy and unique. So that's why it's called prawn chaap. Now put the flame on simmer and cover the lid. As it is big prawns, it will take about 10 to 15 minutes to cook well. So we will get back after 15 minutes. Now as you can see, the prawns are nicely cooked and the gravy become thick and nicely coating the prawns. So the consistency should be thick like this to coat the prawns. Finally finish off with little keura water and some fresh garam masala. Mix well. It really goes great with rice, pulao and biryani. Don't try out roti or naan. because prawns always taste best with rice based dish. I hope you guys enjoyed watching this video. If you like this recipe, please hit the like button, share with your family and friends, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I also have chicken chop recipe over my channel. You can check that out. The recipe will be given on the description below, and you can also click the link above. Thanks for watching. Take care and enjoy.